Welcome everybody to a brand new video. We're gonna be playing some Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 today because I have some positive news about Call of Duty, and pretty much whenever I have positive news to do with Call of Duty, I'm gonna be playing some Call of Duty in the background. If it's bad news, I'll be playing a different fucking game, because if Call of Duty's bad, that's exactly what I'll be doing. But we actually got some good news recently about the next upcoming title, Call of Duty Modern Warfare. In my last video, I mentioned how there were some rumors going around and some leaks claiming that the game was actually going to be censored and a lot of the missions were going to be taken out because they were deemed too offensive, and the media pretty much got their way and that those missions were going to be removed and the game was going to be a lot softer in depicting war than it was initially going to be. However, I am very happy to announce that this is no longer the case. Infinity Ward actually came out and said that they are not going to be censoring this game. They are still going to have it be as realistic as before, and they are going to depict war as faithfully as they can. That's not exactly word for word what they said, but I am paraphrasing. They came out and said that they are not going to be censoring this game, which I am so happy about. I can completely stand by this. There is one scene that they are going to be removing that is actually scrapped, and supposedly it's a scene where there was a piece of dialogue where a Russian soldier, I believe, said something in regards to a little girl saying that she should be kept because the general likes him young, something along those lines, basically hinting at the fact that this little girl is going to be raped later on in the story. And that is really fucking dark, and honestly, my personal opinion, I don't really mind that scene or that piece of dialogue being scrapped from the game, because that is extremely fucked up. That is almost too gruesome even for me to handle, and me personally, I don't really think I find a lot of things offensive. I realize that it's just a video game, but when it comes to depicting war, I understand that these things probably do happen in war, but keep it war related. I understand that children probably do get raped in war, which is absolutely horrible. I don't even want to talk about it in this video. I can't wait to get demonetized. Not that I even make money off of YouTube. I don't actually make any money off of YouTube, in case you guys are wondering. But yeah, I don't think this game necessarily had to go as far as to depict child molestation in the game. I think that is maybe just a step a little bit too far. Rape happens in war. It doesn't matter if it's against children or if it's against adults. Rape happens, and I think that's all we need to know. And I'm sure that somehow that will be in the game at some point, which is kind of disturbing to think about, but you know, we're trying to depict war as accurately as possible, and unfortunately these things happen. To Infinity Ward, all I have to say is thank you very much for coming out and putting a statement saying that you're not going to be censoring this game. And the reason they actually took out that scene and scrapped it wasn't because of the media's pressure, but because they simply just didn't like the scene. They didn't feel like it fit into the game, and they felt like maybe it was a tad bit too far. So I can totally understand where they're coming from. I'm completely fine with them scrapping that scene because it is really just fucked up on so many ways. I'm not gonna lie, when I heard the news that they were going to be censoring the game, that kind of put me off a little bit. I was really considering whether or not I was still going to buy the game if they were going to be censoring the campaign, but now that they came out with this statement saying that they're not going to be doing that, I can happily say that I'm still looking forward to buying this game just strictly based off of the campaign. I almost see the multiplayer as a bonus at this point. If it's bad, whatever, I still bought it just for the campaign, and if it's good, well then that's a bonus. And I'll be very happy if the multiplayer is good, because the multiplayer for Call of Duty hasn't been great over the past few years. I'm not gonna sit here and say that I hated every single Call of Duty multiplayer experience in the last year. Modern Warfare Remastered was pretty great. World War II was great towards the second half. However, Black Ops 4 was just my breaking point. I couldn't fucking stand Black Ops 4. It's such a bad game, and it still is a bad game. I keep hearing about the horrible things happening to that game recently in terms of like loot boxes and such, and I'm so happy that I stopped playing that game, because if I was still playing that game and they released the Locust only in supply drops and I had absolutely no chance of getting it, I would have been depressed. I would have just fucking hated it. And if I didn't quit Call of Duty when I did, I definitely would have quit it now. When I say quit Call of Duty, it's kind of a half-truth. I didn't 100% quit Call of Duty. I still play Modern Warfare 2 on PC, as you see, once in a while. However, when it comes to the recent ones, I can't get by them. The business practices are just heinous and really just anti-consumer, and I don't want to have anything to do with it, which is why I'm buying the next Call of Duty for the campaign, because the campaign is usually good in Call of Duty. I'm not going to be getting my hopes up too high for the multiplayer, because every single year we think multiplayer is going to be great, and then they find some way to fuck up the game with microtransactions, supply drops, etc. And I have a feeling that this year is not going to be any different. They're going to be removing the season pass, but what does that mean for loot boxes and making money in other ways? Is this game going to be aggressively probably monetized even more so than we've seen in Call of Duty Black Ops 4, because they need to make up that revenue somewhere else. If that's the case, well then the multiplayer is going to be absolutely terrible. But we have absolutely no details about the multiplayer whatsoever at this point, so I'm not going to speak on that until we actually see some gameplay and see where this game is going to go. I just realized that I probably should record my videos more often during daylight. My face cam looks a lot better today. Normally, whenever I record my glasses, you guys can see the reflection in my glasses from my screen, but that simply isn't the case right now, probably because I'm recording in daylight and that's just not a factor anymore. I should take tips. I should record videos during the day instead of at night. Unfortunately, with my schedule at work, it's kind of difficult to do that because I usually start work towards the afternoon, like middle of the afternoon, about 12 o'clock. And then I work until the late evenings, usually around 8 o'clock. And so recording videos in the daylight isn't exactly a privilege that I have every single day when I record videos. However, I'll definitely try and find the time to make videos during the day because my face cam looks way better at the moment. Also, my lighting is better because I have lighting from outside and lighting from the side as well. But anyway, guys, with all that being said, I'm gonna wrap this video up here. What do you guys think about this news to do with Call of Duty? Are you happy that the game isn't going to be censored? Or are you a little crybaby who gets offended by everything and you want the game to be censored to shit and not replicate war whatsoever? Can't wait to piss off people by saying that. But regardless of how you feel, whether I agree or not, what do you think of this news? Are you happy about it? Are you sad about it? Leave it in the comments below because I'm very interested to hear your guys' opinion. But without further ado, guys, I'm gonna wrap the video up here. So yeah, guys, that's pretty much the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed, make sure you smack the like button. If you want to stay up to date with my content, please be sure to subscribe. I'll have my last video in the corner. If you haven't checked that out already, definitely make sure to check it out. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks very much for watching. Peace out.